Bowing, or ojigi, is perhaps the best-known form of Japanese etiquette. Bowing is so important in Japan that most companies provide training for their employees on the proper ways to bow. Historically, ojigi was closely associated with the samurai. The rise of the warrior class during the Kamakura period led to the formations of many well-disciplined manuals on warrior etiquette, which contained instructions on proper ways to bow for the samurai. It was during the late Edo period when samurai bowing etiquette spread to the common populace. Nowadays, bowing is a fundamental part of social etiquette that represents Japanese culture, emphasizing respect in social ranks. The custom of bowing can be more complex than most people think. Bowing can be used for introductions, appreciation, apologies, and greetings. Bowing in Japan can be divided into two categories: zare, bowing while kneeling, and itsure, bowing while standing. Bowing while standing originates from the waist. The deeper and longer the bow, the stronger the respect and emotion. Basic bows are usually done with a straight back, with hands at the sides for men, or clasped in front for women with eyes down. Informal bows are usually made to a 15-degree angle, perhaps just tilting the head forward. More formal bows are deeper at a 30-degree angle. The etiquette on bowing also includes the appropriate depth, length, and response. For instance, when a person maintains a bow for longer than expected, it would be polite to bow all over again. This often leads to a long exchange of lighter bows. Bows by a person of lower status are deeper, longer, and more frequent than bows of a superior. A superior addresses a junior, generally with a slight nod of the head. Some may not bow back at all. Apologetic bows tend to be deeper and longer than all the other kinds of bows. The back is bent about 45 degrees, the bow lasts no more than 3 seconds, and the head is lowered. In cases of begging an apology, people crouch down to show submission or deep regret. Bows of gratitude follow a similar pattern of extent. In some cases, a kneeling bow is also performed, sometimes so that the forehead touches the floor, saikeri, or most respectful bow. Shaking hands is not popular among the Japanese, but exceptions can be made for foreigners. Bows can also be combined with handshakes or done before or after handshakes. Japanese culture and traditions are varied, complex, and interesting. Knowing the proper way to bow and greet people will help you ease your transition in your new environment in Japan.